Let's make a chain. Multiple of 2 plus 1. And put the marker in the mid chain. I made 220 chain. Then put the marker into the next stitch. Then another 220 chain I made. So total of 441 chain. I am putting the mid marker and making another 220 chain. To be really honest, this is totally customized scarf, and most important part is that mid stitch. So the number of the chain should be any number. So I'm done making chain. That's a mid marker. And again, if you miscount and one or two missing, that's fine. Add two more chain. Then you make one double crochet into fourth chain from the hook. So I made two chain. So 1, 2, 3. I'm showing you the three chain. That's one double crochet I would count. So go into the fourth chain, make one double crochet. So after this, you already made two double crochet. Actually, three chain count as one double crochet. Then you just made the one double crochet, so count two. Then after that, make double crochet in each chain until mid chain. And please remember, first and last row will be same. One double crochet in each and three double crochet in mid stitch. Here comes mid stitch. Three double crochet in mid stitch. Again, first and last row, double crochet in each except the mid stitch. And mid stitch, you make three double crochet. So I made three double crochet in mid stitch. Then now you put the marker back onto the mid stitch of those three double crochet. Then double crochet in each stitch until last. Row number 2, chain 3. You count those chain 3 as one double crochet. Then one double crochet in next stitch. Then repeat of chain 1. Then skip one stitch. So next stitch you make one double crochet. Then chain 1 and skip 1 and then double crochet in next. So you repeat with some bracket before the mid stitch. Again, people using different number of the chain. So when to stop, it's up to you. Okay? it close to mid-stitch. I just made chain 1. Then I am going to make 1 double crochet after skip 1. After this double crochet, there's one more stitch before the mid stitch. So I am going to make 1 double crochet into the one stitch before the mid stitch, but no more chain 1 because you're not skipping any more stitch. Okay, so now mid stitch, chain 1, then double crochet into the mid stitch, then chain 1 again, then make one more double crochet into the mid stitch. After this second double crochet, you make one more chain. So in the mid stitch, chain 1, 1 double crochet, chain 1, and 1 double crochet and chain 1. So in the middle of the chain 1 space, that's the next mid stitch. And after the mid stitch, make 1 double crochet. Then start with some bracket again. Okay? It's gonna be same method. Repeat of double crochet, chain 1, skip 1, then double crochet in next stitch until last 2 stitch left. And remember, at the very beginning you made chain 3 and 1 double crochet and start bracket. So last 2 stitch would be double crochet in each. And again, you know, this is not the certain pattern. You know, if you have missing, you know, stitch or too many stitch, it doesn't really matter, you know, as long as, you know, it straight, not increasing or decreasing, and the mid should be V-shape, fine. Row 3, chain 3 to start, and I made 2 double crochet in next 2 stitch because I want to use that chain 1 space. That'll be easier. So again, after, you know, 2 double crochet, you have to start with some bracket, chain 1, then skip 1 and 1 double crochet in next. And mid stitch is always same, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1, double crochet and chain 1. That's into the mid stitch. There you go. I made 1 double crochet into the chain 1 space. Okay? Then chain 1. Then skip that double crochet. Then make 1 double crochet into chain 1 space. You don't really have to, you know, follow my instruction really, because it's really up to you. The basic is chain 1 and 1, you know, stitch skip. Then make double crochet into next stitch. So it's really up to you. There you go. I'm just showing, you know, making double crochet in between the two double crochet in previous row. You can also do exactly same as row number two. Okay, the important thing is the V shape. Okay? The first and last row in the mid stitch is only three double crochet straight into the mid, but the rest of the row you have to make chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet, and chain one. That's the mid stitch. As long as you keep V shape in the middle, the pattern, it's really up to you. So in this video, I did repeat combination of row number 1, 2, and 3. Sometimes I did row number 1 and 3 and back to row number 1 and 2, 2, 3. It's up to you, and when to stop, it's up to you. But remember, the last row should be one double crochet in each, then three double crochet in the mid stitch. That's all you have to remember. Okay? And rest of the rows, to keep the V shape in the middle, again, chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet, and chain one. Those five stitches into mid stitch. That's about it. Again, I'm showing row 3. We start 3 double crochet, including the chain 3. So, row 3 at the end should be 3 double crochet. But again, you know, one stitch missing, don't worry about it. Nobody knows, really. Okay? Enjoy!